Today I am going to discuss about water soluble vitamins. Hi everyone, I am Manoranjan Burman and you are watching my YouTube channel. B complex vitamins and vitamin C are water soluble vitamins. They are not stored in the body in large quantities except vitamin B12. For this reason, water soluble vitamins must be continuously supplied in the diet. Most of these vitamins are readily excreted in the urine and they are not toxic to the body. Water-soluble vitamins form coenzymes that participate in a variety of biochemical reactions which may be related to either energy metabolism or hematopoiesis. Water-soluble vitamins can easily be destroyed and washed out during food storage and preservation. Now let's talk about the individual water-soluble vitamins. First, I am going to discuss about vitamin B1, which is known as thiamine. Thiamine acts as coenzyme thiamine pyrophosphate, which is mostly associated with the carbohydrate metabolism. The enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase catalyzes the irreversible conversion of pyruvate to acetyl-CoA. This reaction depends on thiamine pyrophosphate coenzyme. Thiamine pyrophosphate plays an important role in the transmission of nerve impulses. Deficiency of vitamin B1 causes beriberi. Beriberi is mostly seen in populations consuming exclusively polished rice as a staple food. There are two major types of beriberi. Wet beriberi that affects cardiovascular system and dry beriberi that affects the nervous system. Next one is B2, which is known as riboflavin. Riboflavin through its coenzymes takes part in a variety of cellular oxidation and reduction reactions. Coenzymes, flavin mononucleotide, insert FMN, and flavin adenine dinucleotide, insert FAD. Flavin coenzyme participate in many redox reactions responsible for energy production. The coenzyme FAD and FMN are associated with certain enzymes involved in carbohydrate, lipid, protein, and purine metabolism. Riboflavin deficiency symptoms include fissures at the corners of the mouth, glossitis, that means smooth and purplish tongue, and dermatitis. Next, I'm going to talk about B3. That is known as niacin. Another name of niacin is nicotinic acid, niacinamide, dietary niacin, nicotinamide, and tryptophan, which is an amino acid that contribute to the synthesis of nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, that is NAD+, and nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate, NADP+. The coenzymes NAD+ and NADP+ are involved in a variety of oxidation-reduction reactions. Niacin deficiency results in a condition called pellagra. The disease involves in skin, gastrointestinal tract, and central nervous system. The symptoms of pellagra are commonly referred to as 3Ds. Chronically low or without niacin deficiency may result in diarrhea, dermatitis, and dementia. And if not treated, it may rarely lead to death. This is the 4th D. The next one is B5. Which is also known as pantothenic acid. Its metabolic role is coenzyme A. The function of pantothenic acid are exerted through coenzyme A or CoA. Coenzyme A is a central molecule involved in all the metabolisms like carbohydrate metabolism, lipid metabolism, protein metabolism. There are more than 70 enzymes that depend on coenzyme A. Vitamin B5 deficiency is very rare. If there is deficiency of vitamin B5, the person will develop paresthesia. Paresthesia is a numbness or a burning feeling that occurs most often in the extremities such as the hands, arm, legs, or feet. It is same as pins and needles feeling. Next, I am going to talk about vitamin B6, which is also known as pyridoxine. Other names of pyridoxine are pyridoxal, pyridoxamine, pyridoxal phosphate. Insert PLP is the coenzyme of vitamin B6, which is closely related with the metabolism of amino acid. That means transamination, deamination, and decarboxylation, etc. Pyridoxal phosphate is required for the synthesis of the precursor for heme synthesis. Catecholamines are involved in metabolic and nerve regulations. Synthesis of catecholamines requires pyridoxal phosphate. Pyridoxine deficiency is associated with neurological symptoms such as depression, irritability, nervousness, mental confusion. Severe deficiency can lead to convulsion and peripheral neuropathy. B6 deficiency can lead to reduction in heme production and resulting microcytic hypochromic anemia. Next is B7, which is also known as biotin. Biotin directly acts as coenzyme. Biotin enables the body to metabolize proteins, fats, and carbohydrates. If we talk about gluconeogenesis from pyruvate, the conversion of pyruvate to oxaloacetate is a biotin-dependent reaction that is essential for synthesis of glucose from non-carbohydrate sources. Acetyl-CoA is the starting material for the synthesis of fatty acid. The conversion of acetyl-CoA to malonyl-CoA is a biotin-dependent reaction. It also contributes to keratin, which is a structural protein in the skin, hair, and nail. The symptoms of biotin deficiency include loss of appetite, nausea, dermatitis, glossitis. Biotin deficiency is uncommon since it is well distributed in foods. The next vitamin I am going to talk about is vitamin B9, which is also known as folate or folic acid. It acts as coenzyme. Tetrahydrofolate insert THF and dihydrofolate insert DHF, which are used in DNA synthesis. It is important in new cell formation. Folate works with vitamin B12 to form hemoglobin in the red blood cells. Folate deficiency is probably the most common vitamin deficiency observed primarily in pregnant women. Folate deficiency can lead to impaired DNA synthesis. Due to a block in DNA synthesis, the maturation of RBC is slowed down, leading to macrocytic RBC. Eventually, folate deficiency can lead to megaloblastic anemia. Folic acid deficiency in pregnant women may cause neural defect in fetus. Hence, high dose of folic acid is recommended in pregnancy to prevent birth defects. Next, I am going to talk about is vitamin B12, which is also known as cobalamin, or they have other names like cyanocobalamin, methylcobalamin. Vitamin B12 plays an important role in the general cell metabolism. They are essential for normal hematopoiesis and maintenance of integrity of the nervous system. Dietary vitamin B12 have to bind with the intrinsic factor for their absorption in the intestine. Intrinsic factors are released from parietal cells of the stomach. Vitamin B12 deficiency can lead to pernicious anemia, megaloblastic anemia, neuronal degeneration, demyelination of nervous system. Vitamin deficiency can affect the nervous system also. The last water-soluble vitamins I'm going to discuss is vitamin C, which is also known as ascorbic acid. Vitamin C plays an important role in human health and disease. Scurvy has been known to man for centuries. Ascorbic acid helps to form collagen. Vitamin C requires for bone formation. It helps in wound healing. Vitamin C has immunologic functions. It enhances the synthesis of antibodies and increases the phagocytic action of leukocytes. Vitamin C acts as antioxidant and reduces the risk of chronic diseases such as coronary heart disease. Vitamin C reduces the risk of cataract formation. Deficiency of vitamin C results in scurvy. This disease is characterized by spongy and sore gums, loosened teeth, anemia, decreased immunocompetence, delayed wound healing, hemorrhage, osteoporosis, etc. This was about water-soluble vitamins and related deficiency diseases. Thank you for watching.